emozione.
Could you?
Emozione.
My name is
Nia. How old are you?
12 years old.
Good. And how are you?
I'm okay.
Good, very good. And where do you live?
I live in Fort 409 Tamsin, House 15.
Okay, good. And where do you live?
I live where the area is in Town City. I live in a normal apartment with my family, and there are my father, my mother, my brother, and me.
Okay, great. And who do you live with?
I live with my mom, my family.
And who is in your family?
My family have mom, dad, and my brother.
Okay, let's go on to a few questions. So, what did you do last weekend?
I studied for my test. Yeah.
Okay, which test was that? What subject?
All subject.
Okay, good. Okay, and where did you go on your last holiday?
My last holiday is in the other countries. It's in the capital of Hungary, is Budapest. And I feel like the country in it.
Is the parliament on the water in Budapest?
No, it was made by God.
Okay, good. Okay, good answer. Okay, what do you usually do in break time at school and why?
In my break time at school, I usually prepare the next lesson. Books and notebooks, and I also bring water because I feel tired after a lesson, so I will talk with my friends.
Okay, good answer. And what do you usually do in the morning before school?
Of course, I wake up and brush my teeth and tidy.
Good. Okay, let's move to part two. So now I'd like each of you to talk about on your own about something. I'm going to give each of you a photograph and I'd like you to talk about it. So here is your photograph. It shows somebody doing her homework. Can you tell me about it?
She is in her bedroom because I see the background is a shadow, and in the foreground she is her laptop and a bag. She is lying on that. And it's some because in her hand have a lollipop, she and in her under her head is a book.
Good job. Okay, and here is your photograph. It shows some people getting their lunch. Can you tell me about it?
It shows three students
this part of the test, you're going to talk about something together for about 2 minutes. I'm going to describe a situation to you. So, can you both have a look at this picture, please? So after leaving school, you and your friend have decided to take a gap year and work in Britain. Here are some jobs they are considering. Talk together about the reasons for choosing or not choosing these jobs and decide which job you will apply for and why. I'd like you to talk together for about 2 or 3 minutes. What job will you probably do in the future and why?
I think I will do a cooker. Because I can do a lot of delicious food for people.
And what job will you probably do in the future and why? University is important to get a well-paid job. What what subject at school do you need to be good at to do your dream job?
I think I have to be good at math because it helps me to.
Which job do you think are overpaid and why?
In my opinion, the dentist's job is overpaid because I think they just need to take care of people's teeth and give advice for them because they receive a lot of money for an hour. So I think this is an overpaid job.
Okay, that's the end of the text. Okay, I'll give you some feedback. We'll start with you. I think you need to be more confident. I know that there's a camera and it's a test and it's nervous, but you need to be more confident when you talk, and that'll help the pronunciation. I don't know if the camera will pick up the way that you speak, but your pronunciation is good, but it'll get better when you're louder. There are some grammar mistakes that you use, I want to be, and when it should be wanted. So there's a few grammar mistakes in there. But every question I asked you, you gave me a good answer, and it was easy to understand. So you answered the questions well. So good job. Your vocabulary is quite limited, so there was a lot of times you were trying to find a word to like put in the sentence. So I think you need to spend more time studying vocabulary, and then that'll affect your fluency. You'll be able to talk much better if you learn more words. Your grammar you need to work on as well. So a lot of the sentences, we knew what you were trying to say, but it wasn't coming across as clear because the grammar wasn't there. You need to listen to the questions carefully. So I think a lot of the questions, I don't think you understood properly, and you answered something. So you understood the questions, but you couldn't explain the answers, you feel? Okay. So, I can't give you an example, but I'd ask something and you'd sort of answer like on topic, but you wouldn't actually answer the question. So, I think really listening to the question and making sure that you answer what's asked, I think that's important. But I think a lot of it comes down to just studying grammar and vocabulary because it's quite nervous being in front of the camera. So I think studying more, and then that'll help you fluency and you'll get better.